the...
Beginning, before we built New Jerusalem, we used to explore just like this. Small groups setting out for the horizon, looking for resources, trying to make sense of the world we'd been thrust into, trying to find a way forward. It was a hard time, but I can't deny that it was also exciting. I think it's part of our nature to be wanderers. Our ancestors crossed entire oceans on flimsy wooden boats just to see what else there was.
Is it weird to feel nostalgic for a time I never experienced? I just think I could have contributed so much more back then.
It's not weird, but it wasn't all sunshine. People died. Yemo, Calvin, Isaac.
I know, Al. They were family to me.
Sorry. It didn't mean to reopen old wounds.
It's a legitimate point, but I don't think it invalidates the sense of wonder we felt. That's what kept us going.
Thank you.
so much history here that we can't see.
Wonkai, I've been watching you solve these puzzles and this body replication tech. It's incredible. It just casually blows up the very foundations of our society. You can say that again. Making even just one of us is bloody hard. We're not like toasters. You don't just weld together a couple of wires and a motherboard and call it a day. Not to mention how hard it is to even find some of the materials. And this thing just, poof, new human. It was. Or was it? And even if it was, sorry to be heretical, but does it matter? If we can figure out how this works, we can finally, easily create more people. We can grow. We can expand. We can build a real civilization. Isn't that worth pursuing? The mayor seems to think so, but why? What are the actual reasons? Wasn't the whole point of the simulation to teach us to think for ourselves? The Founder may have been the first, but so what? That doesn't automatically make her right. Assuming that that's even what she wanted, which I'm really starting to doubt. Of course I do. I'm Melville. Now, go solve some more puzzles.
This body replication technology is proof of just how vital this expedition is. We may not know how it works and what its limitations are, but the technology itself isn't even what really matters. What matters is to expand our imagination, to realize that other futures are possible. I'm glad you see it that way too, 1K. After all, the world is better with you in it, isn't it? Thank you.
Keep going.
Thank you. If we believe that life is inherently valuable, if we think that other species are worth preserving, and we recognize that most of the universe is barren, then it follows that we have a duty not only to defend life, but to spread it. If life is the most valuable thing in the universe, then perhaps, in a sense, the cosmos itself is depending on us to do this. Like birds carrying seeds to uninhabited islands. Maybe that's our role in the galactic ecology.
Melville?
What is it now?
Why did you upload a picture of your hand?
Why do you care that my hand is in the picture?
Your hand isn't in the picture. It is the picture.
I like it. It's very artistic.
Let's stay professional, everyone. It's not right to make fun of Melville's comically absurd inability to take decent pictures. She's a hyper-advanced humanoid machine, not a photographer.
You'll pay for this, Byron. Every one of these clouds seems to contain exactly the same amount of energy. This looks like it has something to do with energy generation. Am I reading this right?
Thank you.
Looks like Prometheus has given us a way to circumvent some of these puzzles.
So each puzzle has a backdoor. I guess the mythological Prometheus was kind of a trickster, so that tracks.
I wonder what it was like when the ancients were still here. Their world seemed so lively.
Not always in a good way. Interesting times are great to read about, but rarely great to experience.
That's true. But they left behind so much art and philosophy and religion, and so many strange stories. Is New Jerusalem like that?
It was, in the beginning.
Thank you.
It's an old saying about how, in the end, the sea will claim everything. I have no doubt that this is true. In the long history of the human species, entire regions have disappeared under the waves. Places like Beringia and Doggerland still echo in our cultural memories. But we shouldn't forget that life began in the sea. We are the children of the sea. And it's not through floods and ruin that the sea will claim everything, but through us.
Now, I have to talk science fiction for a bit because I love science fiction, but it drives me nuts. There's this cliche that shows up over and over, and every time someone uses it, everyone pretends it's really profound. It goes something like this. A scientist invents something good, but, oh no, it's actually really bad. You could have something that makes your life better, but no, you can't. How dare you even want it? That's hubris. That's playing God. And it's never anything that reflects the real world, right? It's never, oh no, you invented a vaccine for cervical cancer. Oh no, you invented a new class of antibiotics. Oh no, you cured malaria. How dare you? Those diseased mosquitoes are way more important than human lives. How did science fiction become so reactionary? You know, if we all thought this way, you guys wouldn't even exist. At least Alex agrees with me. She has good taste.
Thank you. As we continue exploring the cold northern reaches of the island, the contrast between the harshness of this place and the softness of New Jerusalem becomes more and more pronounced. There is a kind of madness in what we are doing, going to a place that is so hostile to our existence. That does not mean there is nothing to love here. There is, in fact, a great beauty, but it is a hateful beauty. A beauty you can only love because there are places that are not like this. And yet, it is precisely this hateful beauty that the people of New Jerusalem fail to see, and so cannot understand their own blessings.